Echo 2-6 to command. Colonel, we've got eyes on 3 Kong in the North Woods. One of them is armed, and our donkeys just spotted another trench. Maybe the base is near. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Copy. Over.
been searching for you for so long. I heard you had a hidden command base. We could never find it. Some of us started to think that you might be dead. But Colonel McCullough said you were out here somewhere.
Just kill us already.
Something.
What? They're animals. It's gonna slaughter us.
Letting us go.
Tell your colonel you have seen me now, and I have a message for him. Leave us. The woods and the killing can't stop. together. Strong.
Let's go! I get out from here! I'm just gonna put this down.
Look around.
Come. Thank you. I see, girl. I think you human. Oh, but you ape. Like me. No, no, go down.
How long have you been here?
Long time. Long.
Thank you.
Where did you get this?
That place. I find a long time ago after zoo. I look for food. I find human zoo. Zoo for sick. Big walls. Sick human. And then they all get sick. All dead now. A long time. Long time.
Bad humans. Soldiers.
Soldiers.
Is it far? Can you take us?
Human zoo? No, go back there. Everyone dead, I come here, very safe here. Never go back. No.
Please, you must take us.
No, can I take? No. Look, more snow, cannot go, must stay. You eat, you rest, stay here with me. Here, you keep. She keep.
I don't know.
But she was you.
She has no one else.
I see you look at her just now. Look sad.
One. The other was killed by human.
Soldier. Human zoo. Soldier.
I don't know. Maybe.
Then. Maybe. I take you.
closer. Keep them safe.
Must pay. It was a mistake bringing you all. This is my fight. I will finish this up. Join the others.
Thank you. and Napoleon. Custer. And Sitting Bull. You're probably not much of a reader. Where were you? We came upon your herd. We got lucky. But I was surprised you weren't with them. I hope you don't come to regret sparing his life. He's quite a good shot. Have you finally come to save your apes?
I came for you.
For me? Who did I kill that night?
My wife. My son.
Did you know I was here?
I was told you were coming. That more soldiers from the north would be joining you here.
Joining me?
To finish us off. For good.
Who told you that?
Let's go. Thank you.
5, 4, 3, 2. String him up, donkey.
Bad place. Bad place. What you see? So small.
What did the Colonel promise you? You really think he'll let you live after we're gone? You let them call you donkey? You are a... Colonel won't see you.
Interfere with the work again and I'll begin slaughtering the apes one by one. Understand? I need that wall.
Apes need food and water.
They'll get food and water when they finish their work.
Not finished.
You know, you're very emotional. What makes you think you're in a position to make demands?
Soldiers who are coming here, they're not coming to join you, are they? I saw men outside on the wall preparing for battle.
They told me you were smart, but that's impressive. No, they won't be joining me.
They are against you.
They fear me.
Why? Because you kill your own men. We found bodies. Something wrong with these men.
Jesus Christ, you are impressive. Well, you paint quite a picture when you must think of me.
I think you have no mercy.
Thank you. mercy. Do you have any idea what your mercy would do to us? You're much stronger than we are. You're smart as hell. No matter what you say, you'd eventually replace us. That's the law of nature. The irony is we created you. We tried to defy nature, bend it to our will. Nature has been punishing us for our arrogance ever since. 10 months ago, I sent out recon units to look for your base. My own son was a soldier with one of the units. One day, he suddenly stopped speaking. He became primitive, like an animal. They contacted me and said that they thought he'd lost his mind, that the war was too much for him. Then the man who cared for him stopped speaking, too. He stopped speaking. That the virus that almost wiped us out, the virus that every human survivor still carries, had suddenly changed, mutated. And that if it spread, it would destroy humanity for good this time. Not by killing us, but by robbing us of those things that make us human. Our speech, our higher thinking, would turn us into beasts. You talk about mercy. What would you have done? It was a moment of clarity for me. I realized that I would have to sacrifice my only son so that humanity could be saved. I held that gun in my hand for a long time. I pointed it at my only child. He looked at me, trust in his eyes. Even in his primitive gaze, I felt his love. I pulled the trigger. It purified me. Made my purpose clear. I gave the orders to kill the other infected, all of them. Burn their belongings and anything that might spread contamination. Some of the men questioned my judgment. I was asking them to do what I had done, sacrifice their friends, their family. Of course, they refused. Them killed too. Others with children deserted into the woods. One of those cowards fled to my superiors up north. They tried to convince me this plague could be dealt with medically. That's when I realized that they had learned nothing from our past.
You killed them too.
What did I do, preacher?
You severed their heads, sir.
Except for the one I spared, me of my command, they would have to meet me here and do it themselves. This used to be a weapons depot. They turned it into a relocation camp when the crisis was just beginning. But the weapons are still here, inside the mountain.
How many men will be coming?
Probably all of them. But don't get any ideas. The only thing they fear more than me is you apes. This is a holy war. All of human history has led to this moment. If we lose, it'll be the last of our kind. It will be a planet of apes. And we will become your cattle. Look at you. You think I'm sick, don't you? if his destiny was to inherit your unholy kingdom. I'm glad I did.
whatever's out there.
Sweep the area. Put him in the pen.
Thank you.
You must go. Maurice was right.
Still cannot escape mine. Go. Thank you. for them.